Good morning. Scott Morrison has this morning admitted he's unsure if his new scheme to help first home buyers will force housing prices up. Chris O'Keefe is travelling with the Prime Minister in Sydney's Outer West and filed this report.
Well, with 5 days to go until Election Day, Prime Minister Scott Morrison has landed in Western Sydney in the marginal seat of Lindsay, one he hopes a coalition can pick up off Labor. But the PM was backing in his new scheme to help first home buyers. Essentially, at the moment, first home buyers need to come up with a 20% deposit to try and buy a home. The PM said the government will guarantee that loan, meaning that people only have to find 5% to get into the market. The PM says it's a good idea because it helps first home buyers get their foot on the first rung of the property ladder. But interestingly, Labor was quick to back this plan yesterday. The PM today said he cannot guarantee if this scheme will in fact push property prices up.
It's difficult to say. It's difficult to say, but I do know this. Labor's housing tax will force the value of your home down.
Now, this week is shaping up as a pretty frantic week for Scott Morrison. He is slightly behind in the polls, 51-49. So it's looking more and more likely that Labor will win this election. But the Prime Minister will not die wondering. He'll be travelling all around the country to convince voters to stick with him.
Chris O'Keefe there. And the opposition leader is today zeroing in on the marginal Liberal seat of Reid in Sydney's West. Live now to political reporter Airlie Walsh. Airlie, this comes as fresh opinion poll figures are released.
Yeah, figures which show a spike in Bill Shorten's personal approval rating. So let's get straight to those numbers now. In the two-party preferred stakes, the numbers remain unchanged. The coalition is on 49. Labor is on 51%. If that was replicated on Saturday, Labor would win government. Now, in the primary, both sides remain low, 39 to 37. That indicates preferences will be crucial come May 18. Let's move on now to the preferred PM stakes. The gap has narrowed. Scott Morrison is on 45, but Bill Shorten is up 3 to 38. Now, that follows the most emotive and compelling moment of the campaign. The opposition leader brought to tears as he defended his late mother's legacy off the back of a story published in News Corp newspapers. Bill Shorten, often accused of being robotic, was authentic and raw, and that may well have resonated with voters. Now, the opposition leader this morning was campaigning in the Western Sydney seat of Reid. The marginal electorate was held by outgoing Liberal MP Craig Launday, a staunch supporter of Malcolm Turnbull. But given his departure, Labor fancies its chances of stealing this seat. And while both leaders were campaigning in marginal seats today, Clive Palmer spotted in a much more comfortable seat, Mark. 5 days out from the election, Mr. Palmer seen dining there at a Fijian restaurant.
That is strange. Airlie Walsh in Canberra. Thank you. Well, there's a storm of controversy this morning after a Sydney father says he was kicked out of an A-League game for trying to take his disabled daughter to the bathroom. Jared Brevi filed this report.
Sydney FC has been recovering here at Balmoral Beach after an emphatic semi-final victory, but it has been somewhat overshadowed by this incident in the stands. Long-time FC supporter Rory Carroll was at the game with his disabled daughter. He claims she needed to go to the toilet, so he tried to use the one closest to him, but he was denied entry because it wasn't in his ticketed area. He was directed to another toilet further away. That caused an argument and he was evicted. Other spectators filmed as police moved in, and that video has now gone viral.
You want to kick me out because he said so, because I can't take my disabled daughter 5 metres.
New South Wales police are standing by their decision to evict Mr. Carroll, saying he refused to cooperate with seating protocols. The Football Federation of Australia and Sydney FC say they spoke to Mr. Carroll overnight and they're now investigating the incident.
Victoria police have apologised for a shocking case of mistaken identity after wrongly arresting an innocent man, leaving him hospitalised with a severely broken arm. Live now to Sam Cucciara for more. Sam, what more have police had to say?
Morning, Mark. Police have just held a press conference this morning. They say they're deeply sorry for this botched operation. They've called the incident appalling and they've admitted to stuffing this one up. It was very early on Saturday morning when specialist CERT police were chasing a stolen car and a suspect in a violent home invasion and a carjacking. Instead, they've mistakenly broken their way into some units above a bookshop in Fitzroy here in Melbourne. That's where they found Nick Demopoulos, a completely innocent man. He was thrown to the ground and arrested by those CERT police. He had his arm broken in several places and his shoulder was also shattered. He's since undergone surgery in hospital. Let's take a listen now to what police have had to say just moments ago.
Very clear to us that police stuffed this one up. And I have to say, I'm appalled by the extent of the injuries. And on behalf of Victoria Police, I'm very deeply sorry.
The Professional Standards Command of Victoria Police has now taken charge of this investigation. Victoria Police has also referred this to the anti-corruption watchdog IBAC here in Victoria. Meanwhile, Nick is continuing to recover in hospital this morning, and we are told he's now planning legal action against Victoria Police. Mark?
Sam Cucciara, thank you. A 29-year-old man has been charged with attempted murder and a Queensland police officer is recovering in a hospital after he was stabbed in the neck with a pair of scissors. Paris Martin has the details.
As the 29-year-old man waits in the Richlands Watch House to front a magistrate this morning, police have released vision of the moment he was arrested. He was tackled to the ground and handcuffed in Clipper Street at Inala around 3 yesterday afternoon after allegedly stealing a shovel from a nearby home and attempting a carjacking, threatening the residents of the house. He'd been tracked by the police helicopter and the dog squad from a nearby shopping centre on Brisbane's south side, where only about an hour earlier, he'd allegedly stabbed a senior constable in the neck with a pair of scissors. The officer's female partner then tasered him twice, but he got away. Police say the officers were speaking to the man about a relatively minor matter when, without any warning, he attacked. His motive still remains unclear, but he's been charged with a number of offences, the most serious being attempted murder. As for that male officer, he was rushed to the Princess Alexandra Hospital, where it's understood he underwent surgery last night. He remains in a stable condition.
A Queensland rapper arrested in relation to a suspicious death is due to face court in Coffs Harbour this morning. 26-year-old Coscan Marius was arrested last night over the violent death of Gold Coast father Dre Nova. Mr Nova's badly battered body was found in a home on Friday, sparking a major investigation. Queensland detectives are expected to apply to have the accused extradited. In a bid to track down an armed robber, police have released this vision from a hold-up at a subway in Sydney's west. CCTV shows the masked man pulling out a handgun before entering the Kings Park store and forcing a staff member to open the cash register at 6:30 on Tuesday last week. The suspect made off with about $1,000 in cash. A man is clinging to life and another seriously injured after a horror Mother's Day shooting in the New South Wales Hunter region. It's understood the stepbrothers got into a fight at the Bingleburra property when a 35-year-old man was shot in the chest. A 28-year-old man then allegedly fled the scene before turning the gun on himself. Both men were flown to hospital. The suspected gunman is in a critical condition. Well, a pilot has safely landed a passenger jet without its front wheels after they failed to deploy. It was a nail-biting moment for the 89 passengers on board when the call to evacuate went out over the loudspeaker of the Myanmar National Airlines plane. Passengers on the flight reported seeing smoke rising through the cabin as it touched down, the jet coming to rest on its nose. No one was injured in the rough landing.